Dave here, coming at you from Progwarts once again. Got another no BS reaction for you. Time for me to expand my boundaries just a little bit, and I'm hoping I can expand yours a little bit too. So thanks for joining me on this little trip. And this is a continuation of a trip, really, because today I'm getting back to Cardiacs, continuing my descent into their decidedly quirky and unique rabbit hole. So what I'll be listening to today, as I work my way through their catalog chronologically, is a very early song entitled As Cold As Can Be in an English Sea. This version is coming to us from the compilation Archive Cardiacs, which is a bunch of their music from about 1977 to 79. So going pretty far back. This is very early in their career. And this is a suggestion I got from multiple viewers, one from Looney Lotto 4363 and also from Unk 4140. So many thanks to those folks for suggesting this for me. I much appreciate it because I don't know where I'm going and it's easier than randomly picking out songs. So let's jump into this. But before we get into the song, just a quick reminder or two, if you'd be so kind, please hit the like and subscribe. Follow me along on my little journeys here. And if you are socially media minded, my links are below and you can look and find those. And also take a look at the link to my all progressive rock station on Live 365. That's called The Expanse, and I think you might like it if you want to check it out a little bit. So, meanwhile, here we go with Cardiacs, As Cold As Can Be in an English Sea. Buckle up. Okay, lots going on there. Now, they fool you a little bit by giving the impression they're going to start with something a little more straightforward, a little bit more kind of accessible, a little more mainstream, with, you know, some chugging riffs that are reminiscent, really, of early new wave stuff, such as maybe The Cars. And they kind of drag you into thinking, okay, this is going to be a little something less unusual, but no, maybe not. They have a quick break, then they go into a second session, which to my ear actually had some strains of Yes, or early Genesis in its tonality. Maybe some influence showing there. I don't recall whether or not they were influenced by progressive rock. I almost have to think they were, and maybe that's a part of my brain that actually is remembering that's what I read somewhere along the line that's bringing that up. But I hear the influence there if it was intended. If it's not, still there. You know, sometimes it's hard to escape that stuff. But so it's an interesting blend of new wave and very early new wave and, you know, progressive rock from the early days, the more English progressive rock in that section, which is a little bit unexpected because these guys have been tended to know to really bring in influences from all over the place. They're incredibly eclectic and just pull all these different things in. Some of it almost sounds less like rock or pop music and a little bit like Calliope music or circus music or something like that. So it sort of surprised me a little bit, and I was enjoying it. Of course, they get into the verse and what may be a chorus. I don't know. It's hard to say. Their song construction is, of course, as you might expect, a little bit unusual and doesn't tend to fit the typical mold you might expect in a pop song, so very clearly. But as they get in there, of course, the very off-kilter singing, even in the way he's phrasing it and breaking words apart syllable-wise in some awkward ways or unusual ways that really throw you off. If I did not have lyrics in front of me, he totally would have screwed me up. Because, you know, like, even at one point, he ends the one phrase with B, and the next one begins, like, a couple beats later with side, and what was beside? So he's kind of screwing with your head a little bit there by the way he is phrasing the lyrics. And the really the lyrical melody itself is a bit, I probably would call it almost atonal, really, if it's not. So, you know, that's on top of a little bit more straightforward, a little more rocky kind of bed, harmonic bed, musical bed, instrumental bed. There's the word I'm probably looking for. It's all music, Dave. So on top of that, I'll be damned. I am utterly and completely lost through a lot of this as to what time signature they're playing in or what beat they're playing in. It is not something you're going to pick up right away. This is not disco, folks. This is not boom, 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 boom. They've got something else going on, and it's over my head. You know, I've said I'm a drummer, but I was not that good of a drummer, and I could handle that. So they lost me a little bit. They do switch in at some parts into pretty much a 4-4 rhythm and keep it pretty straightforward, but that's kind of short-lived compared to what else is going on. And it's interesting to note that this, at least to my experience up to this point, is an unusually long song for them. You know, normally I'm kind of blowing through these things in maybe 3.5, 4.5 minutes on the outside. This one's going to be 7 minutes, so there's a lot going on here already. And we're only 2.5 minutes in, and we're nowhere near being done. So that's, as always, Cardiacs keep it interesting. They keep it surprising. You're never quite sure what's going to happen, where they're leading, or what they're going to do. So let's keep it moving here. I'm going to back it up a little bit because I think I started to step on the next verse or whatever. the next grouping of lyrics. And we'll go from here.
We'll be right back.
There we go. Okay, so, that is interesting. Did not expect that. But again, I think really my experience with cardiac so far is it's pretty much always about the unexpected. That's kind of the way things roll. I've yet to be able to predict what I'm going to hear with any of their music so far. So this is something that I find an interesting gem, and I guess that's part of it being early music by them, that this to me really shows a bit of a preview of what the band will be, but not quite obviously to the level that they developed into. I don't know, at least what I've heard so far. My first video with them, I think I threw out the question, is there such a thing as prog punk? Can there be progressive punk? And that to me right there may have been a really good example of something like that, blending in elements of new wave and punk, which were on the rise around the time this would have come out, somewhere between 77 and 79, or been written 77, 79, while progressive rock was sort of had crested and was on its way out. It was no longer trendy at that point in time. It was actually being looked down upon by a lot of those who rose in the punk, especially the punk, but the punk and new wave movements who were kind of like, screw this virtuosic bullshit and all these extended songs. It's too damn complicated. We just want to rock and roll, and this should be accessible to the masses, and you should be able to enjoy it without having to be classically trained to play it. At the same time, I'm going to say there are things these guys are doing that extend well beyond what you typically would associate with punk rock in terms of musicality and composition, but there's all that in there. There's little sections in here where they really kind of seem to almost crank up the distortion a bit, and the tempo picks up, and it really gets kind of chugging. Little, I would almost call it metal, but to me, the speed it was going was more punk, especially English punk, more so than perhaps American punk. And at the same time, I'm hearing sections that really, again, put me in mind of Yes and or Genesis, with some of the apparent complexity of the playing, especially the drums. The drummer was a bit off the hook on this one, as far as I'm concerned. And digging and all that, and it was really kind of, you know, surprising where they went with it, because to my experience with them up so far, it almost sounded too mainstream. Even the progressive part sounded too mainstream for these guys. There wasn't any of the kind of the wacky musical breaks that I'm used to, or the very chaotic changes in time signatures and tempos. There is a bit of that, and you can kind of feel, I guess, where this is them in their embryonic stage. And it's mixed in again with the new wave, but it is really kind of cool. I'm going to take back what I said a little earlier, though, about the vocals perhaps being atonal. I don't think they necessarily were, at least in that second portion that I listened to. I did catch more of a consistent melody that I think was probably all in the same key. Don't hold me to that. I could be very wrong. But it was very much off kilter and unexpected. That's where you really heard some of the other cardiacs that I've listened to thus far in the vocals. And this is part of me says where he's kind of all over. And that style, I'm going to just be honest, I'm never going to love. But I recognize it as being very unique at the same time. And certainly I got to expect it's not a matter of him not being able to sing a tune. That's compositionally what he intended. I don't think I followed exactly what the lyrics were about. I almost want to pull them back up and take a peek. It just, taking this all in at once and reading at the same time for me, so much going on because I'm trying to hear all the music at once. And, I'm not sure what he was getting at. I'm not sure. I'll probably have to go back and read it. Probably somewhere in there is some message about the chaos of life. That's my best guess. But he kind of lost me a little bit in there. And, I'm pretty good at most lyrics being deciphered, but I'm just not following on that one in particular around there. But nonetheless, a pretty cool song. Out of all the stuff I've heard of theirs so far, that is probably the one that would come closest to something that I would put on a playlist to listen to it again, because overall I enjoyed it. I didn't find it quite as dynamically challenging or as chaotic. I honestly, let's be frank. I definitely would say these guys are an acquired taste. They are not a band I think in most cases people just listen to the first time around and grasp. And I think because there's so much happening and there's so many influences being pulled in and so many things happening all at once, that it can be difficult, I think, to follow it. And if you were listening to that without a lyric sheet, I'm sure it can confuse the living daylights out of you because of the phrasing and the way he puts the lyrics together into the song. There's a part at times when I hear some songs out there, some music, where I feel like lyrics were written and the music was written, and maybe they weren't necessarily written together, and whoever wrote the lyrics, the singer maybe wanted to put them in there, and maybe wrote the lyrics himself and wanted to put them in there as they were, and they were forcing the phrasing a bit. And to me, a lot of times that ends up feeling awkward and a little bit forced, a little bit just not quite in line. The music doesn't flow nicely. I get it. You wrote something, you really like it, you got a nice turn of a phrase there, things like that, and you don't want to change it much to fit the song and the flow and the rhythms of the song, but you end up sort of putting something in there that just feels a little bit off and just doesn't flow as much as you would like. And that's the way I've experienced some songs out there. Sometimes I also wonder if that's a little bit what happens with Cardiacs, is they wrote the lyrics the way they wrote the lyrics, and Tim Smith, I presume, wrote them. He being the mastermind behind it all, he wrote it how he wanted to write it, and he didn't want to change it. And if it's awkward in the song, screw it. That's what they do. They're awkward. They don't care. They're not going to be constrained by things like meter and tone and tempo. He's going to put it in there. One way or another, he'll figure out how to make it fit, but damn it, these are the lyrics he wrote, and he wants them that way. No idea if I'm talking about anything that's accurate or can be applied to Cardiacs or not. So this is just me kind of speculating a little bit, because they're an interesting band. They definitely are a band I want to continue to explore, and because they're just so interesting. They really are. I can see why in many ways they're very influential for those that enjoy them and can, in probably many ways as musicians, probably better appreciate some of the things they're doing than I'm able to as easily as they are. But I don't know, man. It's a fun and fascinating band. They always keep it interesting. They always keep the energy up. Even if the lyrics are getting a little dark, there's a lightheartedness to it all. So very fascinating. So thank you very much, guys, for the suggestion there. I appreciate it. I'll be continuing with something a little bit newer next time around. I've got a lot of Cardiac songs on my list to work my way through. So that is coming up. What about the rest of you? What are your thoughts on this? Have I totally misunderstood? You think I'm way off base on this? Let me know. Drop some comments in there. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know what you think of the song versus what you think of what I think of the song. Anything you got to throw in there. I'm interested to hear it. That's the fun part of music, is sharing and talking about it and experiencing it, not just listening to it, but also appreciating it together. So let's do that if we can. Drop me some comments. And meanwhile, hey, thanks again for watching. I appreciate all of you that come along for this. It's great to have you along for the ride. And, you know, keep it up if you could. Don't forget, subscribe if you could, to make sure you keep up with everything. That's all I have for you today. So just let me remind you, as always, never be afraid to deviate from the norm. Keep it proggy. And this is Super Dave, signing off.